Monday.com and Asana are major players in the project management world. They have both been around for over a decade and are staples across many businesses. But how do they stack up against each other? I've used a variety of project management software, and the best way to determine which is better is by comparing these five essential features: task management, analytics, integrations, user experience, and pricing. We did make a video comparing the two solutions a few years back in 2019, but both Monday.com and Asana have implemented a lot of updates since then. With this new video, you'll have the most accurate information when deciding between the two. To start things off, we have task management. Arguably the one that matters the most when picking a project management software. In my opinion, Asana takes the crown here. Don't get me wrong, Monday.com offers a great variety of pre-configured options such as a vast template library and 30 types of column customizations. In addition, it offers multiple workflow views and time tracking just like Asana. But when you boil it down to just task creation, Asana has more flexible and granular control over project structure and organization. Users can add multiple subtask levels within each project and have access to more dynamic task manipulation. This means you can group and sort tasks in various ways, making it easier to manage complex workflows and keep your team on track. Next, we have analytics. This is super important when it comes to all project management software, which is ironic for me to say that because I did not do well in my AP statistics class in high school. Mrs. Wells, I hope I made you proud since then, because I now realize how vitally important it is to have a good analytics software. And when I compared Asana and Monday.com together, Monday.com was the clear winner. Mainly because Monday.com provides more variety and customization in data visualization. It has over 40 dashboard widget options and more granular visualization controls, making it easier to create detailed and insightful reports. Plus, their first-party data architecture, MondayDB, is better suited for maintaining large, complex dashboards. As for Asana, its analytic capabilities are pretty basic. Each project dashboard has 6 charts for data visualization, including bar charts, line graphs, donut charts, burnup charts, lollipop charts, and numbers. You can tweak the axes and color palettes, but there isn't much more beyond that. So, yeah, this category goes to Monday.com. But don't get too excited, Monday.com fans, because Asana's integration game is no joke. Just comparing the numbers alone, Monday.com offers about 70 app integrations, while Asana offers over 200. Over 200! And that's not all. Asana includes integrations in all paid tier plans and unlimited integration actions. As for Monday.com, it restricts some integrations to higher tier plans and limits the number of integration actions per month. If connecting your project management tool with other apps is crucial for your workflow, Asana might be the better choice. Now it's time to focus on my personal favorite category, user experience. Having a variety of tools and features are important, but all of that is pointless in my opinion if the UX isn't intuitive. Honestly, both platforms are user-friendly, but they cater to different preferences. Asana's interface is clean and organized, making it easy to navigate and track progress across multiple projects. Monday.com, on the other hand, offers a more visual, customizable interface with its colorful boards and various column types. This can be great for teams that prefer a more vibrant, adaptable workspace for complex projects with different needs. It's because of that adaptability that I'm going to say that Monday.com gets the point here. And also, I really do just like the colors. Lastly, we have pricing. This category comes with a big asterisk mark labeled, "It depends." Both platforms offer free plans, but Asana's is more generous. Asana's free plan allows up to 10 users and includes essential project and task management tools. Monday.com's free plan is limited to just 2 users and 3 boards, which might not cut it for most teams. And yeah, most teams. Though if you're an enterprise, you'll need to call the sales team for both Asana and Monday.com to compare prices regardless. So if you're a PM with a small team looking for a budget-friendly option, then Asana is the better choice. But if you're wanting to invest in a software immediately, then Monday.com offers more tier options to choose from. Like I said, it depends, which means there's really no clear winner here. With that last category, we can compare the final scores. And if you were keeping track, you will see that they both tied. I know that's a lackluster ending, but I'm not surprised, honestly. Both are great software on the surface, but as I explored both of them, I realized they cater to different teams at their cores. If you're an experienced project manager who knows how to navigate agile software, Asana is more appealing. On the opposite end, if you're a PM leading a big team unfamiliar with PM software, then monday.com is preferable because it's more newbie friendly. So the moral of the story, make sure you understand what your team or business needs before choosing one software. If you're interested in giving either solution a try, head to the description to find links to each. Or if you're still unsure, go check out our Asana versus monday.com article for an in-depth comparison. Thanks for watching, and let me know in the comments which software you prefer.